The road to the 2020 Kentucky Derby continues, and this time we go to the Big A Aqueduct for the Gotham Stakes. Full field lined up here at 1 mile on one turn. Let's take a look at some of the top contenders for the Gotham Stakes. Starting at the rail with Celtic Striker. The son of Congrats has pulled off a 2-for-4 career so far. Liked his second victory. That time he came wire to wire at Parks. Speed figure was a little bit high, so I'm not sure if he improved or if the quality of competition. He just kind of ran to his competition and then opened up down the lane. Of course, he had a victory at Monmouth for his first lifetime victory and his second lifetime start. So what I like about him, he's won at a mile, he's won at a couple of different tracks, and now he's going to try Aqueduct for the first time here from the rail. And Informative is also another contender. 8 lifetime starts, so he's probably the most veteran campaigner in the field here. Long shot trainer Uriah St. Louis has done well with some long shots and some stakes races. Picked up a neck victory last race out. 3 back, he also lost by a nose. So he's been competitive with 1 win and 2 seconds in his 8 lifetime starts. War Stopper will take a lot of money. Turf breeding with Declaration of War on the sire's side. Some distance breeding with Curlin on the broodmare side. War Stopper, big victory last time out. 4 length win on 97. Brisnet speed figure. And that's going to make him probably one of the top 2 favorites in this rate. Dale Roman sends out attachment rate. 6 length winner last time out at Gulfstream Park. He was bet down, and that was a nice time. A 101 speed figure. Hardspun is the sire, and a Fleet Alex. He'll take a lot of beating. And I think this one's going to definitely be a contender. Luis Saez in the saddle, and he's going to want to roll on the front end. But I think he's capable of coming just a little bit off the pace like he did in his second lifetime race when he closed at 50-1 against Market Analysis, who will be running this Saturday at Tampa Bay in the Tampa Bay Derby. Necker Island showed some promise as a 2-year-old, winning an allowance race on the undercard of a stakes race day at Churchill Downs. Then came back and opened up the year in the Swale Stakes. He was bet down a little bit, 9-1. Mischievous Alex ran off the screen that day. He gets a rematch with Mischievous Alex, and I think he's going to do a lot better this time. I think he'll appreciate the 1 mile distance. Mischievous Alex did kind of run a hole in the wind the last time out. That was in Gulfstream Park, and that's back-to-back wins where he just aired them out. 9-length victory, a 7-length victory for Mischievous Alex. A mile is probably as far as he wants to go. The son of Into Mischief going to probably be favored or co-favored in this race with War Stopper. Sixto, the son of Curlin, won last out, first time out. Big victory in his debut, and he'll come in a second lifetime start. Speed figure came back high on a surface that was slow, a 91 Brisnet speed figure. And the pace that day was pretty much par for the day once you account for the track variant. I think he definitely could improve a little bit as the distances get longer. Montauk Traffic, another one who picked up a back-to-back wins after losing his maiden race by almost 50 lengths, then won by 4 and then came back with another big victory. 6-1 and 3-1 in his last 2 races. Breeding says a mile should be right there for him. I like the kind of the sturdiness on that mare side. Menifee throws down some runners that seem to have long careers. Jose Lescano rides Montauk Traffic. Flapjack for Calumet Farm. They seem to have a horse in every one of these stakes races. The son of Oxbow going to try to pick up a victory. Won last time out by 4 lengths, but that was in September on the synthetic surface at Arlington Park. But it was done at 17-1 with Sophie Doyle in the saddle. And the outsider on the outside is Untitled. Ran against the intriguing Governor Morris in his last race. That was at Tampa Bay. And then he lost to Mischievous Alex in the Swale Stakes. He had that quick turnaround in 2 weeks. Now he comes back in 3 weeks here in the Gotham Stakes. Who do you like in the Gotham Stakes? Mischievous Alex, Untitled, or do you think on the rematch, maybe Necker Island can improve? Remember, share this video, smash that like button, and hit subscribe as we race you up to the 2020 Kentucky Derby.